pleasure to invite me to give this chance to share our recent work on AI for fast and accurate optical fiber channel modeling. So as introduced by the chair, so we have last several years, we have done a lot of research using AI for compensation of the fiber linearity. And in this work, we mainly use AI to model the fiber channel, including the chromatic dispersion, the linear effect, and the linear effect. Okay, so this is outline. Firstly, I will introduce about the AI fiber channel modeling, the background. And following that, I will introduce how we can use AI to model the single wavelength fiber channel. And following that, we will introduce how we can use to model the WDM fiber channel. And finally, I will introduce how we can use AI to build up a simulation system. Okay, so this is a our motivation. So as we know, so if you are working on long haul and short reach and even long haul transmission, we have to use our software to modulate to model the fiber channel. So kind of basically, we have two wavelength method. So one is the split step Fourier method, SFM. This is a very typical method to model the fiber transmission, the linear equation, which is very high accuracy. But as you know, if you want to increase the accuracy, you have to reduce the step, so which means the complexity is very, very high. You have to spend a very long time to achieve the modeling result. And of course, it's based on theory and external knowledge. And the another method is a well-known GM model. So GM model is different with SFM. So they just estimate the linear noise. So based on this kind of linear noise estimation, you can calculate the signal performance at the output. So it's different with SFM. They cannot modulate the waveform evolution around the fiber. But the complexity is much lower than the SFM. So in many cases, for the linear compensation, we mainly use GM model to estimate the noise. And for both SFM and the GM model, so actually it's just a simulation tool. So it's different with the real system. So we can just know the evolution of the signal. But actually, in most cases, it's the outperformance is different with the real world. It's different with the real system. So that's why we want to think about, is there any method we can combine the advantage between SFM and the GM model. We can achieve we can have a modulation tool with both high accuracy and no complexity. And at the same time, is it possible to have a modeling tool? The result is exactly the same with the real system. Okay, this is our motivation. So also we come to AI. As you know, AI is a very powerful tool, and AI has a very high ability, can fit any linear functions. So because the linear Schrödinger equation is a linear function, so of course it's possible to use AI to learn this kind of linear equation. And compared with the traditional method, AI actually has a low calculation complexity because it's based on parallel computation. So the computing time is much lower than traditional method. Last, it's a data-driven method. So we can achieve a lot of data from the real system. So in this case, we can even model the real system. We can achieve the exact same performance between the simulation and the experiment. So actually, so because AI is so powerful, so they already have a lot of applications for the AI in optical communications. We can use AI for signal processing, for performance monitoring. We can also use it for the linear compensation. So actually, for different applications, of course, you can select a different structure. We can use CNN, you can use RNN, you can either use the GAN adversarial zero network. So of course, we can try to use AI for fast and accurate optical fiber channel modeling. So this is our task, objective. So this is a whole system. This is the transmitter, this is the receiver, and this is the fiber channel. So at the beginning, we just want to use AI tool to model the fiber channel itself. So if it's successful, we can expand to the transmitter and the receiver. So as a final, we can use a single AI tool to simulate, to model the whole system. So if we can model the whole system, we can use this model to even compensate the fiber linearity. So this is so-called end-to-end machine end-to-end deep learning. So our first target to just use AI to model the linear scheduling equation. But at the end, we can try to use this tool to even learn the real function from the physical system. So that's our framework. So in this talk, we just focus on the simulation part. So we try to achieve high accuracy, low complexity, and with high generalization, which means a single model we can use for different channel, different power, different modular format, different lens. So that is very important because you can use for the real applications. So first, let's look at how we can achieve a single wavelength fiber channel modeling using AI. So this is the AI tool we use. So actually, it's a GAN network. GAN, as you know, GAN is an adversarial generator. C-GAN means let's look at this structure. This is a real data set. This is data from the traditional linear scheduling equation. We use the SFM, we can achieve a lot of data. And this is a GAN structure, which has a generator, and this is a discriminator. So this is a GAN, is a typical GAN structure. Generator to generate a lot of data, and the discriminator to compare the generated data with the real data. So if it's different, if the data has a very high difference with the real data, so you can consider it's a fake. So the result will be zero. So if the difference between the generated data and the real data is very small, so we can consider it's a real data. So you can, the output will be one. So that is the basic function of the GAN network. So actually for the generator, it's original from the noise. So which means you can earn the distribution of the data. So C-GAN means that there's another input for the generator. It's we call it conditional vector. So what does that mean? So for the generator, the input is not only the noise. We can also generate a lot of sequence, input sequence. And at the end of the input sequence, we can add a power, which means of a different power, we have a different input sequence. So in this case, we can consider it's like a multi-task training. So in this case, we can have a power generation. So in the training step, you can train the input sequence from minus 20 dBm to 0 dBm. So, but for the output, you can achieve some result, which the generator have never seen that the input power. For example, you can set the output power at minus 10 dBm. So the C-GAN can also have the correct output. Okay, so this is a basic function. Okay, there's some detail. Maybe we can just skip it. Okay, so this is the result we can achieve based on this C-GAN network. Okay, so you can see here. The first we show the generalization on the power. We have for all the figures, the upper figure is the SFM output. The lower level figure is the C-GAN output. You can see for 200 kilometer distance with a different input power, minus 1 dBm, 1 dBm, 3 and 4.5 dBm, the C-GAN output is SFM is almost the same, which means we can learn the distribution of the data. Okay, this is a waveform. You can see it's SFM, this is C-GAN. We can zoom in this part, you can see the waveform is almost same. So which we successfully learn the distribution of the signal around the fiber. So this is the generation result on the modulation format and the input distribution. This is QPSK, SFM, QPSK, 32 APSK, 64 QAM, 16 QAM, with Gaussian noise, we can also add some noise. But for Sika, you can see you can also learn the noise distribution. We can also achieve the same output between SFM and Sika, which means we successful simulate the Langley equation using the proposed Sika method. This is the MSE error. You can see with the increase of transmission distance, of course, the error will be increased. Error means the difference between SFM or our Sika output. You can see for about 1,000 kilometers, the MSE is about 0.01. So it's still in the accepted level. So basically, if the MSE is less than 0.02, you can also consider the performance is acceptable. So which means we can even further increase the distance. So for the accuracy, we think it's good enough. The how about the complexity? Because we want to achieve high accuracy. At the same time, we want to have a very low complexity. So you can see here, the complexity is much lower than SFM, okay, because it's a parallel computation. So first thing, we look at the structure complexity, which means how many multiplexer you have used for this kind of GAN tool and the SFM. So you can see for the first line is the SFM, second line is the GAN. For 1,000 kilometers, and the four, which means the number of the training sequence. So you can see this is the number of SFM, this is the number of the GAN. So which means the max pixel will be about 10 order lower than SFM, so only about 2%. Okay, so this is 200 kilometers. It's also 200 kilometers, about one order lower. And we can also look at the time compensation consumption. This is we compare on CPU and GPU, because with GPU we can accelerate the speed. So CPU SFM is about 400 seconds. I use GAN, we can only use 0.07 second, which is very, very fast, okay? This is for GPU. GPU can accuracy the SFM, but for GAN is even faster. This is for 200 kilometers. So no matter for 200 and 1,000 kilometers, you can see the speed, the calculating speed is much faster. So which means AI is really a very good tool for the modeling. So now, this is just a single channel. How about the multi-channel? Because for many applications, we have to use multi-channel. For the single channel, we choose the generation on the power, and we choose the generation on the modulation format. But there is no generation capability on the distance. So we have to train to 200 and 1,000. We have to train separately. But how we can achieve the distance degradation, and how we can learn the even stronger non-linearity performance. So this is a multi-channel. So you can see for multi-channel, the non-linearity is much stronger. We have XPM, we have full mixing, we have a longer ISI length, the dispersion was also stronger, the SE noise was also stronger. So this kind of performance system is much more complex than single channel. So how we can use AI to learn this kind of complex system? Okay, so of course the first mind we think about is the still follow the single channel case. We can use overall scheme. We can learn the fiber channel. We can consider the 1,000 kilometer fiber as a whole system. We achieve the data from input and from output. We use the input output data as a training data for the AI. But for this kind of system, because it's too complex, it's almost not possible use a single AI to learn the system. So we can think about another two method, which we call it distributed scheme, which means we can have a lot of span. For example, 1,000 kilometers, we can consider every 50 kilometers, we can consider as a span. For each span, we use one model to learn this span, and after we learn the 50 kilometers system, we can extend, we can interact to much more spans. So it's quite similar like the SSFM method. In this case, we can because we each NN model we can just learn a shorter distance, which means the model will be much simple. We can reduce the workload of NN. And for each span, we propose another method which calls feature decoupling, which means we can separate learn the dispersion, the linear performance, linear distortion and nonlinear distortion. So in this case, we can use NN to learn the nonlinear very accurately. For the linear, we don't need to use NN. We just use a traditional method to learn the linear performance. Okay. So this is we call it is data driven and model driven method. So this is a basic structure. You can see for the system we have a many span. For each span, about 50 or even 80, as you like. You can select the span length. And for each span, we have linear model. This is a nonlinear model. This is a noise model. Because for the linear model, we can use one stable, traditional one stable model. We don't need to use NN. Traditional model is enough. We can model dispersion, attenuation, amplification. And for the noise, because the noise model is also known, we don't need to use NN to learn this noise model. We just use NN to learn the nonlinear model. In this case, it's much easier to learn the nonlinear function. So in this case, we can achieve very accurate result. So for one span, if you can learn the performance very accurate, in this case, you can just increase, add much more spans to achieve a long distance modeling. Okay. In this case, we can have a high accuracy, low complexity, and strong generation ability. So, just quickly go through this part.